Something's happened, Desmond. Abstergo has your dad.
Where?
Italy. Same place they were holding you.
What are you two waiting for? Let's go.
There's more.
Hello again, Mr. Miles. I hope this message finds you well, or as well as it can, all things considered. It appears we now each have something the other desires. I propose a trade. Bring me the apple, and I'll return your father to you no worse for the wear. Should you refuse, he will still be returned, albeit much worse for the wear. I assume you'd like to avoid an unpleasant outcome.
I always knew it would come to this. Just not so soon. I wonder if Abstergo even knows what's about to happen. And has this been a part of their plan all along? Maybe they want the world to end. To see it all burned away. Then they'd have their new world, ripe for the reshaping. We talked about looking for another power source, leaving him there. It's probably what he'd want, for us to finish the mission. But I can't. It's hard enough taking a life, but letting one be taken? Knowing there was something I could do about it? Not a chance. Might be I'm risking my life, risking all our lives to save an asshole. What else am I supposed to do? That asshole is my dad.
They're probably holding your father on the upper level, same place they kept you. There's an elevator bank down the hall. Try not to let them see you.
They know I'm here, Rebecca. There's no way they don't.
This was a bad idea.
Welcome back, ladies and gents. I'm your host, Industry 1. This is one of the more action-y parts of the modern day, so let us begin Assassin's Creed 3 Remastered Walkthrough. Hopefully you all are enjoying it. It's been my pleasure to bring it to you. Don't forget to subscribe for more content like this. Make sure you click that bell icon for more notifications so you can be aware of when new videos are up.
Hand over your weapons and come with me, sir.
I can show myself in, but thanks for the offer.
I'd rather this not turn ugly, Mr. Miles.
Then let me through.
Subdue the subject, please.
Where's my father?
You'll see him soon enough. Now be a good boy and wait for security to fetch you.
You're gonna have to climb the rest of the way.
Need eyes on him.
He can't be far.
Where the hell is he?
Your dad could be anywhere. Sorry, but I just don't know where he is.
That's okay. I do.
Thank you.
They really didn't pull their punches during this section, did they? As far as, like, just how nasty the combat is.
Give me the apple. Let's not draw this out. You got nowhere to go, and I've got a gun. Speaking of which, it's the 21st century and you're still running around with only a tiny knife for protection? It's stupid. All right, Desmond. Game's over. Not now. Not now. Я сейчас тут работа. Нет. Get out!
What the hell was that?
I think it's ridiculous how we caught up to him already, but it would not let us, you know, do anything to him.
I invited you here in the spirit of cooperation, but you responded to my hospitality with only violence. I had hoped we might preserve your and further study your memories, but you're not worth the trouble.
This is one of those sections that can be very frustrating because but if you can get them quick enough, that's all it is. But it can be very frustrating if you can't get them quick enough.
Where's Vidic?
Fifth floor.
You also get no cinema explaining anything about him. So when I played this for the first time, I was just like, who in the heck was this guy, you know?
Vidic's office is up ahead.
You. You killed him! Daniel was like a son to me. A sickly son, perhaps, but one full of promise. He accomplished so much. And so well, now you've taken him from me. From us, like the apple. But Lucy, we want to help the world, Desmond. To save it from itself. You keep getting him. All our hard work ruined. You're a banana for all your time. Maintaining the erroneous belief that we are evil. The work we do is wrong. We bring lives here. We save and transform them. You just escape and take what isn't yours!
That's hilarious how they can knock you over like that.
Please don't kill me. I'll let you in.
Desmond walks in because he knows he's a badass.
So fast, Mr. Miles. In case you hadn't noticed, I'm the one calling the shots. Now give me the apple.
You want it? Fine. Here it is.
Wait! No!
You never should have come here. You put everything on the line. For what? So you could rescue your father?
Yeah.
I'd get the power source hooked up before heading back into the Animus. But it's your call.
It's also a little bit of a shame how easily, you know, Vidic went out as well. I think we all wanted that to be a little differently. I mean, he was the main antagonist, you know, throughout this entire series, and he kind of went out way too easily. And also, how would he have been so stupid to know, to not know that, you know, when you have the apple, it controls whatever you want. So he walked into that. It was just, it didn't seem like his character was smart after that.
A new world approached, one that was dark and cold. It would consume us. For we were flesh, and flesh is frail. Though suits and shields might offer comfort, such adornments would not suffice. Not to save us all. So we sought to change what we were. In this manner, we might thrive in a world made poisonous. It was Aita who volunteered to see if it might be done. Aita, my husband. My love. In the end, it changed him. Ruined him. He was made a prisoner of the machines. The body might survive, but his mind became brittle to the touch. He begged me for release. For days. For weeks. For months. I pleaded with him to give us time to find another way. But there wasn't one. Not for him. Not for us. Consciousness but a series of electrical impulses, and the body a vessel to hold these sparks. But it is weak. In time, it decays and crumbles into dust. We asked ourselves then, what if it might be replaced with something stronger, something better? So we forged a new vessel, one that might endure. It proved easy enough to enter. But to leave required something more, something wrong. And so this too they abandoned. I wondered, though, were they right to turn away?
Alright, so all that's left now is to talk to our members.
Hello.
Hey. Do you think killing Vidic set Abstergo back?
I doubt it. I'm sure he pioneered the Animus, but they've had the technology for decades now. Plenty of other people can take his place.
And Cross?
Oh, he was a loose cannon. I doubt anyone's mourning his death. I think these days he was more a symbol than an asset. I'm sorry, I don't mean to dismiss what you did, but it's going to take a lot more than a couple of deaths to stop the Templars.
Did Vidic put you in an Animus when you were at Abstergo? They'd be able to search your memories and track you back here.
Oh, they definitely tried, but I made things difficult for them. You can resist, you can cloud up the transmission, or just refuse to move. Eventually, they would have gotten what they needed. But it still would have taken them weeks.
Vidic threatened to put me in a coma once.
It would have made you more pliable. But if the user isn't engaged, it's a mess. I know they've been working on ways to extract memories and let others sift through those memories. Maybe they're even analyzing mine right now. Maybe they'll find us. I don't know. What I do know is that we've got to get through that door.
Yeah. I should probably get back into the Animus. Hey, so, when this is over, and assuming it all works out, I was hoping I could, you know, come home.
I'd like nothing more. We're almost there, son.
I regret not asking you to hack into the Abstergo servers while you were there. A couple of well-placed relays and we'd be swimming in information.
We have everything we need.
Yeah, except the key.
We're close.
How do you know?
I just do.
I've been poking around a bit. Did you know there are machines down here that make, well, mana?
Wizard mana or biblical mana?
What do you think? Biblical, of course. The Greeks called it ambrosia. The Indians, amrit or soma. Most cultures around the world refer to a divine food, though I'd say its taste is anything but.
You ate something that came out of a 75,000-year-old machine?
And I live to tell the tale.
So? What did it taste like?
Cardboard. Tasted of cardboard. Hardly the stuff of legends, though I wonder if the first civilization didn't taste differently than we do.
Maybe the flavorizer broke.
Flavorizer? You've certainly got away with words, Rebecca. Things are getting worse outside.
What do you mean?
Every day for the past 2 weeks, the sun has been throwing off larger and larger flares. Older satellites are starting to malfunction. I hear rumblings of recalling the crew on the International Space Station. There's already work being done as well to shield power stations and transformers on the ground. Not that any of it matters. This goes far beyond some brownouts. We all saw what's actually coming.
Do you know how it works?
Look, I'm no physicist, but it's something to do with the Earth's geomagnetic field. The flares and mass ejections disturb it, which appears to trigger seismic events. I've tried reaching out to people who might know better, but they all insist it's bunk. And I don't blame them. It sounds ridiculous.
I wish it was.
I'm sorry, but his neck doing that is freaking me out.
Best we finish up with Connor.
All right, one more conversation to go.
Hey, Desmond, didn't Subject 16's...
His name was Clay.
Sorry, didn't Clay say Washington was a Templar?
No, he indicated that Washington came into contact with an Apple of Eden, but beyond that, it's all speculation. Furthermore, judging from the portrait referenced by Clay, the event occurred much later in Washington's life. Perhaps Connor wasn't even involved. It's very hard to know for sure. We'll just have to wait and see what, if anything, happens.
So what was it like being back at Abstergo?
I didn't expect to get out of there alive. It's a good thing Cross broke down the way he did. If he wasn't losing his mind, I'd probably be dead.
I guess he never really recovered.
What do you mean?
When he first came to us, he was exhibiting symptoms of the bleeding effect. It was real bad. He'd just go in and out at a moment's notice. No animus required. Got a little violent, too, sometimes. It took a while and a bunch of therapy, but we thought we had it under control. Once he went back over to Abstergo, though, who knows what they did to him.
I still worry about that happening to me.
He was raised in an animus, Desmond. There's overexposure, and then there's Daniel. Poor guy. That could never happen to you. We won't let it. Hey, when this is all over, we should take a trip somewhere. Celebratory vacation.
Yeah. That sounds nice.
Now listen to you. Italy, Brazil, and the United States, all in the span of a few weeks. And you're complaining about not getting out enough?
Seriously, Sean?
No, not seriously. Are you mad? Trust me, no one wants time off more than I do, right? Do you have any idea how hard it is to crank those database entries out as fast as I do?
The sooner we're done here, the sooner we can take that vacation.
All right, last things. See if there's any other emails. You guys can read those. All right, ladies and gents, let's head back into the Animus and continue our adventures with Connor.
Home stretch, Desmond. I can feel it.